Good evening, I'm Shoghi Mohammed and this is the 7 o'clock news. In the presence of the chairman of the Rashid Equestrian and Horse Racing Club High Committee, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Rashid Equestrian and Horse Racing Club held the 25th race meeting of the season at the racecourse at Asghir. It was held for the Cups of Bahrain Jewelry Centre, Porsche, Chevron and the Rashid Equestrian and Horse Racing Club. Also present at the race were Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid bin Isa Al Khalifa, شيخ سلمون بن محمد بن عيسى الخليفة، شيخ خالد بن علي بن عيسى الخليفة، شيخ حمد بن عبد الله بن عيسى الخليفة، شيخ نادر بن محمد بن سلمان الخليفة، as well as horse racing fans. The event comprised of 8 races. At the end of the race, trophies were presented to the winners. The Minister of Interior General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa has commended the directives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to reinforce its capabilities for the effective application of the provisions of the Penal Code on alternative sentencing and the provision of rehabilitation measures and programs commensurate with the personal circumstances of those sentenced to be reintegrated into society so as to achieve public interest, the desired goals of punishment, and deter any future criminal repeat offences. He said the royal directives reflect the dedication of His Majesty the King to respect the dignity of humans, promote nationalism spirits, and rehabilitate convicts to meet the nature of the crime without jeopardizing the rights of the victims and those affected. He said that alternative punishments are a successful measure to promote justice principles, fight crimes, and prevent them from reinforcing sustainable security factors for the implementation of penalties through considering inmates as part of any society, and their needs to be rehabilitated to limit crimes and enhance the sense of responsibility. He highlighted that Interior Ministry works to develop new mechanisms to expand the implementations of the alternative punishments, especially electronic monitoring and coordination with concerned authorities to ease the suffering of the families of inmates and the psychological, social and economic burdens of those families. He asserted that the royal directives come to reinforce tolerance, love and sense of responsibility towards the family and society, and encourage all to take up the responsibilities towards the implementation of the directives, while citizens become partners in the success of this approach for the best interests of the nation and the community. The Interior Minister said the diversity of legislation in Bahrain in implementing alternative punishments makes it in the lead in reinforcing these laws as a turning point in the civilized Bahraini society and the promotion of modern reformation policy for penalties in the kingdom for the protection of community, security and leadership of His Majesty the King. The Minister of Information Affairs, Ali bin Mohammed Ramehi, lauded creativity of the Bahraini youth in media production, stressing the need to support it with all possible means to ensure sustainability of the national media growth in the prosperous era of His Majesty, King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. Speaking as he patronized the Cinema of Literature function, which was organized by the University of Bahrain College of Literature Society, the minister asserts that the young national competencies are the cornerstone of media development in Bahrain, so as to preserve national achievements and keep abreast of advancements in the media and telecommunications sector. He praised the tremendous efforts of UOB to prepare a generation equipped with knowledge and skills to contribute effectively in the labor market and national development process. The minister expressed appreciation of the films he watched, which shed light on national accomplishments and discussed social issues in an innovative and artistic way. Present at the ceremony were the President of the University of Bahrain, Dr. Riyadh Hamza, Information Ministry Undersecretary, Dr. Abdulrahman Mohammed Bahar, and members of UOB's academic and administrative staff. Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi voted today on constitutional amendments that would allow him to stay in power until 2030. State Run TV said al-Sisi voted in Cairo's Heliopolis district near the presidential palace. Al-Sisi, who has repeatedly said he won't stay in office any longer than the people want him to, hasn't commented on the amendments. Casting his ballot, Prime Minister Mustafa Madbouly urged voters to turn out in high numbers. He said that voting would reflect the atmosphere of stability and democracy that we are now witnessing. Polls opened at 9 a.m. or 700 GMT. Voting will stretch over a period of 3 days to allow maximum turnout. Heavy police and army security was reported at polling stations throughout the capital city. For the second consecutive day, Egyptians in the Kingdom of Bahrain continue to vote on constitutional amendments approved by the Egyptian Parliament. The Egyptian Ministry of Foreign Affairs allocated 140 electoral headquarters in 124 countries where the Egyptian missions are located abroad. According to the National Electoral Commission, every Egyptian citizen abroad is entitled to vote in the referendum. Egyptians vote abroad for 3 days starting yesterday. Egyptians abroad also continue for a second day in a row to cast their votes in a referendum on constitutional amendments. The first day of the referendum witnessed a voting turnout. The number of voters is expected to increase, especially since today and tomorrow are official holidays in most countries. The Egyptian embassies abroad invited the citizens to participate in the referendum on the constitutional amendments, considering that participation as a national action linked to the continuation of the reform and development process, which aims at a prosperous future for the Egyptians.